Today's lesson, upstream and downstream problems. Problem number one. It took about 4 hours to travel upstream. On the return trip downstream, it took the same boat 2 hours. If the speed of the current is 3 kilometers per hour, what is the speed of the boat in still water? What is asked in the problem is the speed of the boat in still water. Still water means the water is stationary, there is no current. Let us represent by X the speed of the boat in still water. Let us construct the following table. In the first column, second row, let us write upstream. Traveling upstream is traveling against the current. So the speed of the boat in still water is being lessened by the speed of the current. The speed of the boat upstream is equal to the speed of the boat in still water minus the speed of the current. The speed of the boat in still water is represented by X, and the speed of the current according to the problem is 3 kilometers per hour. So this speed is equal to X minus 3. The time is equal to 4. The problem says it took about 4 hours to travel upstream. Distance is equal to speed times time. So the distance is equal to 4 times the quantity X minus 3. Let us write here downstream. Traveling downstream is traveling with the current. The speed of the boat downstream is equal to the speed of the boat in still water plus the speed of the current. So the speed is equal to X plus 3. And according to the problem, it's just here, on the return trip downstream, it took the same boat 2 hours. So the time is equal to 2. Distance is equal to speed times time. So the distance is 2 times the quantity X plus 3. The distance traveled upstream is equal to the distance traveled downstream by the boat. So the equation is 4 times the quantity X minus 3 is equal to 2 times the quantity X plus 3. We are going to apply the distributive property of multiplication. 4 times X is 4X. 4 times negative 3 is negative 12. On the other side, 2 times X is 2X. 2 times positive 3 is positive 6. So this is now equal to 4x minus 12 is equal to 2x plus 6. Transpose 2x to the left side. Change its sign from positive to negative. Transpose negative 12 to the right side. Change its sign from negative to positive. So this is now equal to 4x minus 2x is equal to 6 plus 12. This is now equal to 2x is equal to 18. Divide both sides by 2. Divided by 2. Divided by 2. X is equal to 9 kilometers per hour. This is the speed of the boat in still water. Problem number 2. The speed of a boat in still water is 12 kilometers per hour. If it can travel 40 kilometers downstream and 20 kilometers upstream in the same time, what is the speed of the current? What is asked in the problem is the speed of the current. So, let us represent the speed of the current by x. Let x is equal to the speed of the current. Let us look at this table and complete it. Let us write here, first column, second row, upstream. Traveling upstream is traveling against the current. The speed of the boat, if the boat is traveling upstream, the speed of the boat in still water is being lessened by the speed of the current. The speed of the current is x, and the speed of the boat in still water is 12. So the speed upstream is equal to 12 minus x. The distance is equal to 20 kilometers. The problem says if it can travel 40 kilometers downstream and 20 kilometers upstream in the same time. So the distance is 20. Time is equal to distance divided by speed. So the time is equal to 20 over 12 minus x. Let's write here downstream. Traveling downstream is traveling with the current. The speed of the boat downstream is equal to the speed of the boat in still water plus the speed of the current. The speed of the boat in still water is 12 kilometers. And the speed of the current is represented by x. So, the speed downstream is equal to 12 plus x. Remember this. For upstream, the speed of the current is always subtracted from the speed of the boat in still water. And downstream, the speed of the current is always added to the speed of the boat in still water. The distance, according to the problem, is equal to 40 kilometers. It says here, if it can travel 40 kilometers downstream. So, 40. Time is the distance divided by speed. So, the time is 40 over 12 plus x. Let us now form the equation. The time spent in traveling upstream and the time spent in traveling downstream are equal. So 20 over 12 minus x is equal to 40 over 12 plus x. Cross multiply. 20 times 12 plus x and then 40 times 12 minus x. So you have here 20 times the quantity 12 plus x is equal to 40 times the quantity 12 minus x. Apply the distributive property of multiplication. 20 times 12 and then 20 times x. On the other side, 40 times 12 and then 40 times negative x. This is now equal to 240 plus 20x is equal to 480 minus 40x. Transpose negative 40x to the left side. Change its sign from negative to positive. Transpose 240 to the right side. Change its sign from positive to negative. This is now equal to 20x plus 40x is equal to 480 minus 240. This is now equal to 60x is equal to 240. Divide both sides by 60. Divided by 60. Divided by 60. X is equal to 4 kilometers per hour. This is the speed of the current.